Real wild one. Wild one. Wild one. Wild one. Wild one.
I've always benefited from what I've been able to learn from just looking out and watching my audience. That's how I got my sound in the first place. When I started to create the Stooges, we were playing, we were going far afield doing musical experiments and things like that. But it was when I first encountered an audience, I think it was in 1967 at a private party, and they all left the room when we played. I thought, yeah, I think I'm doing something wrong here. So I got down to basics, and from encountering people and seeing what they wanted and seeing what really worked in a real situation where you stand in a room and you're supposed to play some good music for people.
I'm not the kind of guy who dresses like a king.
I'm trying to use, lyrically, I try to use the music as an evocative force to bring things out of me and into the realm of words that I don't even know I was thinking about. They just come out and there it is. I'm like, oh God, so that's what was on my mind, you know? And other than that, I try to describe the world I find myself in. I try to describe the world I would like to create for myself, which is a far removed world from the former, and I try to have a laugh, too, have a good time with it. I don't even know what it is that much about what it is I do myself or what makes it really tick, except that for me to do what I think is a good job or to satisfy myself on stage is more important to me than my life itself. It's on a higher plateau, and then sort of self-preservation and and all the other things, I don't know, water, food, light, sleep, and that comes second, but that's the most important thing to me. And I'd rather go to my grave knowing that I did great shows than sort of knowing that there was a lot of money in my will or something. I really don't, I don't care that much about that kind of thing. So it's very important to me to do good work. And I think because of that, then something's bound to happen.
Cold metal, that's what it be. Cold metal, from sea to sea. Cold metal, it's how we win. And also, how we sin.
I used to play songs 18 years ago, 20 years ago even, not 20, but about 18 years ago, that nowadays, people hear them and they bop up and down and they enjoy them and they open up. But when they first heard them, they didn't. I encountered a lot of resistance. And I used to go out and play what I knew were really good tunes for like these, I don't know, corpses or what they were, mummies. People would fold their arms and stare at the ground and sort of harumph, There was a lot of resistance to what I was doing because a lot of people felt threatened by it musically. In the 60s, in this country, there was an enormous group of FM DJs and programmers who had a vested interest in flower power, and along came I, and they didn't want to know about it, what I'm saying? The Stooges never played the blues.
I Hi, how are you?
Oh, shut up, you little bird bastard.
I'm a wild one.